There are two easy ways to create eye-catching, wavy text in Adobe Premiere Pro. You don't need plugins, you don't need After Effects, and there's no limit to the types of ripples, wiggles, or waves you can produce. Let's kick this off by creating some text. You can select the type tool or just hit T on your keyboard. Click anywhere in the program monitor and type out your text. Then in the Essential Graphics panel, under the Edit tab, we'll style this text up a little. I'm going to select a different font. You can use any font you like, obviously. I'm going with Gibson Bold. I'll set the font size to 500. And keep in mind that the values I use here and later in this tutorial may differ from yours depending on your sequence resolution. I'll make this all caps, centerline the text, and then up under Align and Transform, click these two icons for horizontal and vertical center. So now we have our text, and we're all ready to add our wave effect to it. I'm going to show you two different ways to do this, and which method you use will depend on the type of wave you're going for. If you just want a relatively simple, repeating wave, the easiest way to do this is with the Wave Warp effect. Go to the Effects panel, search for Wave Warp, drag the effect onto your text clip, and you can see that has an immediate effect on the text. And without doing anything else at all, if I play this, this ripple-like animation will just repeat itself for the duration of the clip. If you want a more subtle, natural-looking wave effect, the three parameters you'll want to play with are the wave height, wave width, and wave speed, which all do exactly what they sound like they do. So for example, if I set the wave height to 20, the wave width to 500, and maybe slow the wave speed down to 0.6, and give that a play, we end up with a much softer, more organic, more fluid-looking wave. And I didn't even have to keyframe anything for this. There are other parameters in here you can play with, of course. You might want to set anti-aliasing to medium or high. That'll increase rendering time a little, but it will make the edges of the text slightly smoother. And for a simple, looping text wave, that's all you really need. Now, if you want something that's a little more interesting, something with more dimension and complexity to it, there's a really fun effect you can try instead. Let's delete this. Then back in the Effects panel, I'm going to search for the Turbulent Displace effect and drag that over onto my text clip. And for the moment, you can see that this has really made a mess of things. But this Turbulent Displace effect is extremely versatile and great for adding really organic-looking, liquidy, wavy animations to your videos. With just a few simple adjustments, I'll set the amount to 30 and the size to 300. My text already has a more realistic, wavy look to it. Now, to animate this effect, we do need to add a couple keyframes. I'll click the stopwatch beside the offset parameter to create my first keyframe, and I'll drag that keyframe over to the beginning of the clip. Then for my second keyframe, I'll increase the first value beside offset to 2 or 3 times the current number. Basically, the higher I go with this number, the faster my wave will be. So in my case, with a 4K resolution sequence, this value defaults to 1920, and I'm going to bump it way up to 6000. Then I'll drag that keyframe to the end of the clip. And if we play that, we've got a much more interesting wave here with a lot more dimension to it than we could achieve with the wave warp effect. And again, there are other parameters you can play around with here. There are different displacement types you can try, although I find turbulent works perfect here. If we also keyframe this evolution parameter, we can change the turbulence over time as well. This adds a little randomness to the animation, which gives our wave more of a floaty feel. Just like the wave warp effect, I can increase the quality here too. But if I tried to go through all these parameters and all possible permutations, this would be an hour-long tutorial, and no one wants that. Frankly, you kind of just have to get in there and play with this a little.
My gosh, it's almost as though you're in some sort of a basketball trance.
For example, if we go back to the intro sequence for this video, you'll see that I actually animated a whole bunch of things. I added keyframes to increase and decrease the size of the wave over time, slow it down or speed it up, all to match the motion of the girl swimming in the pool in my video. There's just so much you can do with this effect. So play around and get creative. And with that, I'm off. I'm going swimming.